Sentry's rolling out AI agent monitoring, and I'm going to go hands-on and show you how easy it is to get started. Let's check it out. To get started, we'll head into Insights and drop into the AI agents view. And in here, we'll be in a view that shows all the AI interactions happening within your application. It's really easy to get a ton of useful debugging information out of this. I can see things like traffic patterns, duration of calls happening in the environment, and some of the comparison calls are really useful. So I can see things like LLM generations based on every model that I have instrumented. I use the tool usage view here a ton to make sure that the prompts I'm tuning are actually calling the right tools on the back end. And I can even see token usage and how those different changes are relating to the way token cost is increasing inside of my environment. If I want more details, I can scroll down and dive into the trace view where I can see a customized view of the different spans happening inside of that environment with all the AI information specifically surfaced. So I can see things like this stream text response that shows the information coming back to my application from the LLM. Now, my app is designed to take this, parse it out into a bunch of tool calls, and I can see how those are represented here also. I can see timing on the right-hand side for all of these, token usage, and when I get down to that tool call, I can see the specific inputs going into the tool and what the tool responds back with. All this information is really important because it's typically very hard to get this out, and we're making it very easy to surface as part of the instrumentation we're doing from the SDKs automatically when you turn it on. If I want to dive in and get even more detail, I can click on View and Full Trace, and I'm dropped into the trace waterfall for my entire application. Now, this is where Sentry really starts to shine because I've instrumented Sentry across my whole app, and so I'm getting information from the front end, how it's passed down into my Express and Node backend, how that's calling those LLM calls and the tool calls, what they're responding with, and since I've, again, fully instrumented Sentry, I'm also getting the database calls associated with that. So that tool call makes a call to update my database, and now I'm able to see the performance of that database backend from here also. We're able to debug full stack across the entire application, whether it's in traditional app stuff or inside of the LLM interaction specifically, we get all of it. What's really great about this is I can drop back into the Trace Explorer view, dive in and search for some of those calls here, and I can use this information to go and create alerts or dashboard views that'll let me see or get notified when performance starts to go sideways. So if some of these tool calls start to drive performance down, like maybe response times go way up, or I start seeing failed prompts happen, or application starts crashing from it, I can get notified so I can jump in and start debugging quicker, and I have all that information available to me right away because we're bringing all that context together. Let's see how we set it up inside of the application. So if I jump into the code, here I am in my instrument.ts file, and I've got my Sentry initialization here. Inside of the integrations, you can see I'm bringing in the Vercel AI integration here, and inside of the Vercel integration, I'm setting up record inputs to true and record outputs to true. With that set up, the initialization is good to go, and I can jump into my app and start to bring this into the actual AI calls. All I have to do here is turn on experimental telemetry by setting isEnabled to true and giving the function ID a name, and I'm all set. This call is now going to be instrumented automatically. If we take a look at this call name here and we go back into our Trace Explorer, we can see that's the one that I'm searching for, and so that becomes a really good identifier to search off of inside of the app. I can also come in and grab this span operation here, clear out this information entirely, type in span op, drop that name in, and now I'm seeing all the different calls inside of my environment that are related to stream text. We have a lot more things that we can filter off of, so I definitely encourage you to jump in here and explore, because all of this information can be turned into alerts or dashboard views as you see fit, and it's going to give you a ton more visibility into how your application's performing. Our goal with AI and agent monitoring is to make it really easy to bring all the context of what's happening in your AI applications into the debugging that you already have throughout your application. We'd love for you to give it a try and let us know what you want out of agent monitoring and what would make it more useful for you. We can't wait to hear from you. Talk to you soon.